Hey, it's Danielle here, and today I'm talking about how do you build your business while you're recovering from burnout. A lot of my clients are in that camp, and so I wanted to share some tips with you if you're in that boat as well. So let's talk about burnout for just a moment here. When I'm talking about burnout, it's often combined with fatigue. So energy crashes, feeling physically tired, just not having the energy to do things that you used to be able to do. And that's attributed with the fact that those of us who've experienced burnout tend to have a habit of pushing ourselves even when our bodies are physically tired. And because we have continue to push ourselves and push our body, even when it's saying enough, I'm tired, we eventually create what's called adrenal fatigue, which means our body isn't able to produce or manifest, you know, energy. We basically are kind of mental fatigue and emotional fatigue turned and manifested into physical fatigue. And we have, actual now things going on in our body where our body just isn't able to produce energy like it was. So the good news about this, the first piece is if you have that, or if you know somebody who's in that position, the first thing to know is you cannot run at the same level that you once did or the same level at which other people are. And that can be really tough sometimes because there's going to be a part of you, the doer in you, who wants to get things done. And especially if you're starting a business, a lot of times you feel tremendous pressure to get out there and do what you need to do to build your business. But at the same time, your body's like pushing back saying, no, I'm tired. I can't do this. And so it can be really frustrating. It can feel like those two parts of you, those two sides are at odds with one another. So building a business while you're fatigued means you're going to have to do things differently. You're going to have to shift a lot of your old habits because they're not going to work for you anymore. Okay. So first thing when you're building your business is to recognize that now your number one priority, even though you say making money, getting clients is my highest priority, there's a mindset shift that has to occur if you have adrenal fatigue, because adrenal fatigue means this has been going on quite a long time to the point where it is now manifested into a physical problem within your body, right? And you continuing to push yourself is not going to help you get better. In fact, it's only going to make things worse, okay? So it's like driving around on a body that isn't able to function as well as it used to. It's like driving around on a motor that's old and tired and worn out, you know, like an old car motor, you know, a car that's at 250,000 miles, if it got that far, is not going to necessarily have the same stamina as a car that, you know, is fresh and new and young, you know, has a brand new motor in it. So recognizing that your body has some major wear and tear on it, that now you need to go into recovery mode. You need to go into healing mode in order to restore your physical body, because your body can be healed, right? This is the good news story. Unlike a car engine, I guess you could rebuild a car engine, you know, or put a new engine in, but our bodies can heal itself. So now you're going to move yourself into recovery mode or healing mode for your body, which is really, really important while you build your business. Driving around on a motor that is tired and run down will continue to create further damage as you go along. It's kind of like I have some lawn equipment. I have an edger for the lawn, and it's battery operated. And my old system would be if I plugged in the battery and ran the edger to the point where the battery is getting low, if I let the battery get too low, it actually damaged the motor on the equipment. And so over time, my equipment just didn't work as well. Even though I had a brand new battery in it, the damage was done, right? But now I have new equipment that has a mechanism in place that if I run the edger and the battery gets too low, it automatically shuts off so as not to damage the edger. Well, we need to kind of restore that mechanism in you, because obviously you have a history of pushing yourself past the point where your engine or your batteries run too low. You're continuing to work. You're continuing to push yourself, even though your body is saying stop, enough, right? So we want to restore that mechanism in you that automatically shuts off activity once the body says enough. And so how do you do that? The first thing is to start paying attention to the physical body. Chances are, if you're anything like me or my clients, you tend to be a workaholic. And so you just go, 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 you do, 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 and you're not paying a tremendous amount of attention to your body. So your body might be giving off signals. I need water. I need food. I need fresh air. I need, you know, healthier food. I need to go for a walk. I need exercise. I just need downtime, right? So your body's giving off these signals of what it wants. And it's up to us to start to pay attention to what those signals are and to listen, right? Not to just notice what they are, to listen. So if the body says, I need water, take a break and go get water. If the body says, I need fresh air, take a break and go get fresh air. This can be really hard for those of us who are workaholics because we say, no, I got too much to do. I've got this to do and I got this to-do list and it's this long and it's too hard and I can't take a break. And what the mindset shift here is, because I'm, you know, a mindset coach, I teach people, this is learning to shift your thinking so that you don't continue the habit or pattern of burning yourself out. And the mindset shift here is to recognize that now you have to start making your self-care your number one priority. You have to make you, your longevity, your health, your well-being, your highest priority. Because up until this point, you have made it your lowest priority. Is that true? So you had this big to-do list of things to do. And when you got that done, then you took a break. Then you got exercise. Then, and if you had kids, like you had kids, clean the house, you know, all those chores and everything on your list. And then at the very bottom was take a break, relax. You probably didn't even put those things on your to-do list if you're like many women or many people. So just kind of recognizing the habit or pattern is to make self-care last. And what we want to do is we actually want to shift it up to be first. This is tough. For those of us who make it last, to make it first is tough. Our mind's going to want to fight us on that. No, I've got too much to do. I got a business to run. I got to make money. I got to get clients. I got bills to pay. I'm going to go bankrupt if I don't. Like, so the mind wants to really put pressure on us to continue to hustle, to continue to work hard. And that, while in burnout, or burnout, we'll call it burnout recovery, right, doesn't work. So a lot of people in your world aren't going to get this if they haven't experienced burnout and like adrenal fatigue, exhaustion. So they're going to tell you, you need to get out there and hustle, right? That's a belief that's prevalent in our world. You need to get out there and hustle. They mean get out there and push yourself. And what they mean is push yourself past your comfort zone, force yourself to get out there even when you don't want to, right? But a lot of us equate hustle to, we need to work 70, 80 hours a week. We need to work 7 days a week in our business. And if you're at the point of burnout, that's not physically possible anymore. Your body's going to kick up a fuss and you're going to wind up on the couch absolutely exhausted. So, and I know for some of you who are going through this, you've learned the hard way, right? You just can't push yourself the way you used to. You've got to take those breaks. So number one priority is to start making your self-care care top priority. So what do I mean by self-care? Taking breaks, eating fresh, healthy food. So I'm talking organic, non-GMO. Your body's got to detox. Detox from everything, right? Detox from the foods we're eating. But healthy, natural foods give our body the elements it needs to start restoring itself and healing itself. Remember, the body is great at healing itself if we give it what it needs to do so. So lots of healthy foods, right? Fresh foods, veggies, lots of fruits, making sure they're clean, not with chemicals on them, right? Because adrenal fatigue means we got kidneys are being overworked and our guts off and our organs are all off. And so you don't need to add stressors on it by eating unclean food. Okay. Doesn't mean you have to go overboard and become vegan or anything like that. It's just learning to eat cleaner, healthier foods. Okay. Second part is that, so we're making, you know, self-care high priority. We're eating healthier foods. We're taking more breaks. We're drinking more water. We're putting our health care, or the things we need to do for our own health, on our to-do lists. So we start to actually put, I'm going to take a break. I'm going to take a break could be on there. Drink more water could be on there. Be specific. Drink 64 ounces of water could be on there, right? Starting to put those things on your list teaches your brain that you and your health is now a priority. So it's a mental and physical way to tell your brain and override, listen, we're no longer going to put self-care at the bottom of the to-do list. In fact, I'm going to physically put it on the top of my to-do list, or at the least, very least, put on my to-do list to remind myself each and every day to take those breaks, eat good food, give yourself permission to take a nice, decent lunch break where you can actually make yourself lunch, right? If you're self-employed, this is one of the benefits, is you get to create better balance in your life, meaning more time to take care of yourself in the process of building your business. But it's up to you to choose to do that, right? So you can continue to put it off. No, I'm too busy. You can continue to keep that pattern, but that's what got you where you are in the first place. So it's recognizing, oh, I need to change my patterns so that I can create different circumstances in my life. I can start to restore and heal my body. And the way we do that is to put ourselves in these things called self-care on our to-do list, okay? And over time, they start to become a habit, right? Over time, you start to get better as you do it daily about taking those lunch breaks, about eating healthier food, about eating good snacks, about taking breaks, period, about not working 7 days a week. You know, part of it is learning to put boundaries in place where you are not constantly working. So learning to recognize that that is no longer going to serve you. And so putting days off on your calendar, blocking time off, which means for some people, you're going to have to say no. No, I can't spend the day with you. No, I can't work on this project. And I know with that, a lot of us have some stuff, yeah, buts. We have a lot of yeah, buts of why we can't do that. And so I would just challenge you to look at what those yeah, buts are. And is it worth your health? Is it worth you continuing to be tired and fatigued and exhausted? The bottom line is, and this is kind of the shift that I had to learn at one point, was nobody's going to advocate and stand up for your health and well-being. They're just not. So you have to learn to do that for yourself. You have to learn to take a stand and say, enough is enough. I have to start taking care of myself. And if you don't, nobody else will. So it's up to you. Okay. So those, hopefully those tips work for you today. It's just the start, excuse me, of some things to think about, of what you can shift. But the ultimately what I want to finish with is you absolutely can build even when you're, and I also want to say that it is a good thing to have the space to take care of yourself as a self-employed person. Very hard to do when you work for somebody else, but when you step out and become your own boss, you're able to put structures in your life that allows you to start restoring your body back to health. So congratulations if you have stepped out, started your own business. You're going in the right step. You're definitely going in the right direction. And so just keep it up and start to make your health your highest priority, okay? You do that and you continue to learn about what it takes to grow a business and the steps that you need to take to continue to put yourself out there so your clients can find you, right? Putting those two things together, they can be done simultaneously. So just know you're on the right track. And of course, always reach out to me if you need any help or assistance with anything with this. And please comment in down below if this was helpful. You're welcome to subscribe to my channel. And of course, like the video. Thanks so much, and hope to see you on the next one.